The rampant COVID Delta variant in the US is killing an average of 300 people every day. And Florida, which has a very low vaccination rate, is the hardest hit. Here's US correspondent Allison Petrowski.
Florida finds itself the epicenter of the virus during this Delta wave of COVID in the United States. More than 10,000 people currently in hospital with COVID, a pandemic record, and the patients are getting younger. Testing queues looking like what they did during the early waves of 2020. One in five new cases in America are in this state. Yet their governor threatens to defund schools that implement a mask mandate.
Did you not get the CDC's memo? I don't see you guys complying.
Meanwhile, in Louisiana today, they've brought in a federal assistance team as its largest hospital runs out of ICU beds. The July 4 goal of 70% of Americans with at least one shot finally achieved today, nearly a month behind schedule. And while a return to lockdowns remains unlikely, future booster shots are on the table.
While we desperately want to be done with this pandemic, COVID-19 is clearly not done with us.
While 90 million eligible Americans remain unvaccinated, private companies could be the tipping point. The likes of Disney, Google, Uber, and Netflix all requiring employees to get the jab.
Emotions have overflowed at British airports as the country welcomed vaccinated travellers from the US and EU. Steve Marshall reports.
Hugs, tears, and kisses, all the emotions were on show in scenes reminiscent of that feel-good movie, Love Actually. One of the first flights to touch down was from the United States at 6 a.m., 2 hours after Britain relaxed its COVID restrictions on travel, which meant a lot of those travellers who were fully vaccinated did not have to do the 10-day mandatory quarantine on arrival. Now, there's been a lot of pressure from the aviation industry on the UK government to recognise vaccinations from other countries. And the Heathrow airport boss believes other countries like Australia should take note.
Having led with the most extensive rollout of vaccination of any major country, should be showing a global lead in this to encourage places like the US and particularly places like Australia to get on with their own vaccination programs to get their lives back to normal.
So the UK once again giving us a glimpse as to what might be around the corner for Australia once vaccinations ramp up there.